Design patterns are formalized abstract solutions to recurring problems in computer science, and there are quite a few specifically for microservices. Diving into this technology is nothing short of fascinating. So let's break down some common questions to paint a clear picture and avoid any confusion around microservices. Here is a rundown of some key patterns that can make your microservices architecture robust and efficient. Mastering microservices. Microservices design patterns. This video is an excerpt from my video course Software Architecture from Foundations to Cutting Edge. Service discovery. This pattern automatically detects network locations of service instances to enable seamless communication between services. It helps services find each other without hard-coding addresses. Service registry. Think of this as the phone book for your microservices. It helps connect clients to available instances of microservices. It ensures they always find the right service to talk to. Load balancing. It distributes incoming requests across multiple instances of your microservice to ensure no single instance gets overwhelmed. This improves reliability and performance. Circuit breaker. Just like an electrical circuit breaker prevents damage by cutting off power during fault, this pattern stops failed services from being called repeatedly. It helps maintain system stability and avoid cascading failures. Fallback. When a service fails, the fallback pattern provides a backup plan. It offers an alternative response or action to ensure your application continues running smoothly even when some services hiccup. Sidecar or Sidecar Proxy. This pattern is like having a trusty sidekick for your main container. The sidecar provides auxiliary services such as logging, synchronizing services, or monitoring, enhancing the capabilities of the primary service without adding complexity to it. Adapter. Need to standardize or normalize interactions? The adapter pattern bridges the gap between your main container and the external world. It makes sure different interfaces play nicely together. Ambassador. Acting as the main container's envoy, the ambassador pattern connects your service to the outside world. It can handle things like proxying localhost connections to external services, effectively managing outbound traffic. Routing. It directs requests to the appropriate microservice based on specific rules or configurations. This pattern ensures that requests are efficiently handled by the right service. Failure inducing. It simulates failures to test the resilience and robustness of your system. It helps identify weaknesses and improve overall reliability by preparing your system to handle real-world issues. What microservices problems does the service mesh solve? Microservice architectures solve some problems, but introduce others, wrote Cedar Yugilal in his piece, What is Istio? The Kubernetes Service Mesh explained. When organizations adopt a microservice architecture, they encounter several challenges. Complexity in communication. In a microservices architecture, services need to communicate with each other frequently. Managing this communication, especially in terms of routing, load balancing, and failure handling, becomes complex. Solution. A service mesh abstracts these complexities, providing a unified approach to service communication. Security concerns. Each microservice communicates over the network, which makes it susceptible to security threats such as man-in-the-middle attacks. Solution. A service mesh can enforce security policies like immutable TLS or MTLS for encrypted communication between services. MTLS stands for Mutual Transport Layer Security or Mutual Authentication. Observability issues. With multiple services interacting, tracking performance issues and understanding the flow of requests becomes difficult. Solution. A service mesh offers built-in observability features, including tracing, logging, and monitoring to help track and troubleshoot issues. Resilience and reliability. Services can fail independently, and handling such failures gracefully requires robust mechanisms. Solution: a service mesh provides resilience features such as retries, circuit breakers, and load balancing to ensure reliability. Service discovery and routing. Dynamically discovering and routing requests to the correct instances of services in a distributed environment is challenging. Solution: a service mesh includes service discovery mechanisms and intelligent routing to direct traffic efficiently. What does service discovery mean? Well, when a service instance is created, it needs to be listed so that other services know how to find it. Without service discovery, your services might end up wandering around, lost and unable to communicate effectively. A service discovery means identifying the service location, knowing where the service is hosted, its IP address and port, understanding how to interact with it. This usually involves discovering its REST API endpoints and methods. Think of this as knowing what the store sells and how you can buy from it. Here is why this is crucial. Dynamic environments. Microservices are constantly evolving. Instances come and go, scale up and down. Service discovery keeps track of all these changes. Smooth communication. It allows services to find each other quickly and efficiently, facilitating seamless communication. Load balancing. It helps in distributing requests evenly across all instances. This prevents any single instance from being overwhelmed. When do we create a new instance of a service? We spin up new instances of a service when traffic increases, like a sudden influx of shoppers. An increase in traffic means more instances are needed to handle the load smoothly. Instances get overwhelmed. If a particular service is swamped with requests, adding more instances helps distribute the workload. Instances become unhealthy. Sometimes an instance might be like a store with a broken cache register. In such cases, we need fallback options, more instances, to ensure continuous service availability. So let's sum it up now. The journey from traditional monolithic architectures to microservices has brought unparalleled flexibility and innovation, but it also introduced a new layer of complexity. Embracing these technologies isn't just about keeping up with trends. It's about future-proofing your architecture against the inevitable demands of growth and change. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe to the channel for more updates and tech insights. See you next time.